What if China took over the world? China is the third biggest country in the world and has the largest population on the planet. They have over 1.4 billion people living there, which is more than 3 times bigger than the United States. Whilst China may have the most people in the world, they currently do not have the largest economy on the planet. That title does still remain with the US. That being said though, over the past few decades, China's economy has grown substantially. In the year 2000, their GDP, which is probably the most important metric used by economists in determining the health of a nation's economy, was sitting at 1.2 trillion. That was good for 6th in the world at the time. But nowadays, that number has risen to over 14 trillion, which firmly puts them at 2nd in the world behind the States. Economy aside, China also has one of the best militaries in the world. They're continuing to make massive investments into their military, and now they have the 3rd strongest in the world, trailing the United States and Russia. Aside from all the resources and money, there has been longtime speculation in the media that China intends to be the next major global power. Whether this manifests itself in the domination of the entire planet is unknown, but the belief that the power is shifting from the west to the east has been brewing for quite some time. Many people believe that China is the world's next superpower, and within the next century will overtake the United States as having the strongest economy and the most global influence. With all of that being said, it's not unrealistic for people to start wondering what a China-led world might look like. How long would this potentially take? The method to how China would end up with global power, and the overall ramifications that it would have on everyone's daily life. So, without further ado, let's break down what would happen if China took over the world. Well, first we need to look at how this global takeover would actually happen if it was to transpire. It's impossible to speculate on what would happen if they took over the world if we don't know how they actually did it. For instance, taking over the world by blowing it all sky high with nuclear weapons would be very different than developing a slow chokehold over the worldwide economy. So, how would China actually take over the entire planet? Well, first off, nuclear weapons wouldn't be the way to go about it. There's currently an approximate of 14,000 nuclear weapons on the entire planet. Now, nobody knows the exact number, but people believe that China has roughly 350 of them. That's still a ton of nuclear weapons, but if China was to ever fire one of these on another country in the effort to eventually take it over, then they would most likely get completely blown up by the other thousands of nuclear weapons that the world has, and their attempt at world domination, it would be over. No. If China has any aspirations of becoming a global superpower and then taking over the world, they'll need to play the long game. Now, this is all very complicated, so I'm going to quote an article written by Hal Brands and Jake Sullivan on what they believe to be the two potential avenues China will take in obtaining global power. The article reads, "This road runs through China's home region, specifically the Western Pacific. It focuses on building regional primacy as a springboard to global power, and it looks quite familiar to the road the United States itself once traveled. The second road is very different because it seems to defy the historical laws of strategy and geopolitics. This approach focuses less on building a position of unassailable strength in the Western Pacific than on outflanking the US alliance system and force presence in that region by developing China's economic, diplomatic, and political influence on a global scale." So that was a lot. Let's break it down a little bit. The first option, which was historically attempted by the Soviet Union during the Cold War, is to basically establish an incredibly strong foothold where you're located so that you can focus on military offense rather than defense. Now, the Soviets did this by occupying some select countries, but China doesn't necessarily need to do that. However, they certainly could. If they become such a dominant player in the Western Pacific to the point where they can practically dictate the choices of their neighbor countries, then this will be enough to have a strong base of operations. This would need to extend into island nations in the Pacific and through Asia, basically meaning that most countries bordering China would need to get the okay from them before making any major political or economical decisions. This would also effectively cut any ties that their biggest competitor, the United States, would have in this area. If we think about it, the United States has done something similar to this in North America. Where would Canada be without the ongoing trade with the US? If they cut all ties to Canada, would Canada's economy be able to survive? If China was able to do this with all of their neighbors in Asia and the Pacific, then a military attack on China gets increasingly more difficult, and one could see how China's influence could then spread through Europe as well. Option number two is a little bit more underhanded than that. In the first first option, it would become increasingly clear that China is distancing themselves from the West and creating a barrier, whether that be through military dominance of their neighbors or by other means. Option two basically brings the world to them. They're currently involved in the Belt Road Initiative. This is a massive infrastructural project with the intention of creating strong supply chains all throughout Eurasia. It was announced in 2013 by China and is going to bring great economical gain to China along with global influence. The West has reportedly thought this deal is a glorified way for China to take global influence away from the United States and become the center of the world. That could all be true, to be honest, and that's largely what the article I quoted argues. If China is able to continue to grow their economy to a point where they dwarf the United States and other countries, if they're at the forefront of cyber advancement or artificial intelligence, countries will have to come to China, and as long as China is capable of turning this economical power into geopolitical power, then they will effectively be able to take over the world in that way. Basically, becoming the center of the world and making it so that other countries are so reliant on their trade and their supplies that it would be impossible to go against their will. All of this being said, a great World War III is unlikely if China was to play their cards properly and take over the world in the ways I suggested. Now, if the first scenario was to happen, then it would be very possible one day the Chinese would assert military dominance over other countries and slowly take over them over a span of decades. However, if the second option happened, then they might not ever do this, but through their sheer economical dominance, other countries would be forced to change and morph themselves to live in a China-governed world, basically meaning that they took them over anyways. So, if all of these things happen, how would that affect us? Well, China is currently run by the Chinese Communist Party, who has been ruling over China for decades. This party is in complete control of everything that goes on in China, from the military to the police to all of the government. It's also said that this party has a very strong hold on the media in China and what is regularly fed to the people. Articles and news pieces slamming the government aren't typically tolerated in China at all. It's also said that if you want to have any major career advancement, publicly supporting the government is a must. Any opposition to this will risk persecution by this government. The Chinese Communist Party runs everything and is capable of controlling the public and maintaining order by feeding them exactly what they want to from the media. Therefore, if China truly was to rule the world, or at least had such a chokehold on other countries that they had to rely on China to survive, then videos such as the one I'm doing right now wouldn't be allowed. Complete freedom of speech would kind of go by the wayside, and everything that you say would be consistently monitored. Also, even if I did post a video like this, you most likely wouldn't ever see it, because unless I'm overwhelmingly praising the choices of the government, this video would be banned and wouldn't see the light of day. I also want to hammer that point home about being monitored. Right now, there are high-resolution cameras on every single corner of every single Beijing street. Also, everyone's online activity is consistently surveyed by the government. If China was to take over the whole world, then this level of surveillance would expand worldwide, and everything you say and do in your regular life would have to be censored. This is because anything you say or do, that could be brought back to you at a later time and used against you. The day-to-day life might not be super great either if China was to take over. China currently claims to have alleviated poverty from their nation, a problem that they were dealing with for decades. However, these reports have met harsh speculation, with most people believing the truth to be somewhere around a quarter of China's population is in poverty. Now, if China was to become the center of the world, I guarantee their economy would shift dramatically, and these statistics, they might not hold true anymore. But if they did, then it's very possible you or I wouldn't make a living wage. That's certainly a scary thought, especially because speaking out about it, that would be forbidden. I also want to quickly touch on language and culture. I would imagine that we all wouldn't immediately shift to speaking Mandarin. However, learning it as a second language would most likely become a must and forced by the Chinese government. Chinese-made film and art and literature would also be pushed far more and studied by the public. With all of that being said, if China took over the world, life would change dramatically, so much so that it's hard to fully cover in a 10-minute video. However, if it was to happen, then I don't think it would be for at least decades and potentially even centuries. I also don't think it would be a sudden shift either. If China was to take over the whole world, this would be a long, drawn-out process, no matter which route they chose to go. I don't think that nuclear weapons would ever become involved, and I also think it's very likely that an organized organized war wouldn't take place either. If it did take place, then I think it would be a last ditch effort from potentially the United States to stop China's global domination from advancing any further. If they were to take over the entire planet, then it probably would be through the economy, and it probably would resemble the Cold War a lot more than any other big battle we've seen in our time. Again, I cannot stress enough how a topic like this is hard to fully break down in 10 minutes, and I also want to note that if something like this was to take place, there are so many millions of variables in play that truly understanding what life would be like if China ran the world, it's almost impossible. But that doesn't stop us from being able to speculate, and with that, I would love to hear what you guys think on the topic. Hit me with some comments on what you think would happen if China took over the world. How would they do it? When would they do it? And what would life be like if they did? Also, please make sure to hit that like button, smash the subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Nicholas Playalog, and I'll catch you next time.